This video is dedicated to my new favorite singer. Despite being a teenager, this girl is a go-getter with many number ones on the charts and 6 Grammy nominations. Can you guess who I'm talking about? Yes, Billie Eilish. Did you know that her new project has something to do with James Bond? And how about how rich is she? Do you know how much her net worth is? I'm gonna answer all of these questions and more in this video, so subscribe and hit the little bell button and get ready for what's coming. This year, 18-year-old Billie and her older brother Phineas wrote the main song for the last James Bond movie, No Time to Die, which will be released in April this year. And I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I'm more excited to listen to Billie's new song than to watch the actual movie. Do you feel the same? Just imagine how Billie's collaboration with the legend Hans Zimmer would sound like. That song already has an Oscar in my head. The two previous James Bond songs, Writings on the Wall by Sam Smith and Skyfall by Adele, both won Oscars, so with this new one, there will be another win for the Bond team. Do you think Billie's James Bond soundtrack will win an Oscar or not? Tell me your prediction in the comments. Speaking of awards, the singer is now waiting for the Grammys since she has 6 nominations, including 4 general categories: Record of the Year, Album of the Year, Song of the Year, and Best New Artist, which makes her the youngest artist in Grammy history to receive nominations across all 4 major categories. This shows you what a fruitful year she had. When asked how she feels about her nominations, Billie said, "I don't care if I don't win anything at all. It's such a cool opportunity, and I'm so excited to go and see some of my friends." Her 8 gold and 4 platinum singles in the US proves how successful the singer has been this year. That, plus her immense popularity, gets her winning chances up very, very high. Speaking of her popularity, did you know that last year they filmed a Billie Eilish documentary? This Apple documentary was directed by RJ Cutler and produced by Billie's label, Interscope Records. Did you know how much the budget for this documentary was? Between $1 to $2 million. The documentary is said to be deep access into Eilish's private moments with the family and behind the scenes of her public appearances. And I, for one, cannot wait to watch the documentary. What about you? Did you know how much Billie Eilish got out of recording this project? She reportedly got paid $25 million for Apple TV plus documentary. Before this, her net worth was estimated roughly at $6 million, and now she has increased it by $25 million. She might just become the new youngest billionaire soon, beating Kylie. I'm just saying. Since I don't really like to talk much about the artist's net worth, I'm gonna change the topic because this is already becoming depressing for me. On another note, Billie is a vegan, and last year she launched her own line of sustainable clothing. Recently, she also launched her collaboration with H&M. T-shirts, caps, sweatshirts, and socks all in Billie Eilish's style. There is no doubt that Billie is a great inspiration for her generation and all other generations. In 2019, Billie raised awareness for animal rights and started using her platform to encourage fans to become vegan. On her world tour, Where Do We Go, which will begin in March of this year, she has decided to ban plastic straws and ask her staff to carry reusable water bottles with them. What do you think about what Billie is doing for the environment? Do you think this helps to save the world? Tell me your opinion in the comments. Now, back to Billie. Billie was just 13 years old when she became sort of known, and since then she has achieved success after success. In 2017, she released her debut EP called Don't Smile at Me, which reached the top 15 in the US, UK, Canada, and Australia, and we all know what happened after that. Even with all of this success, Billie has stayed very humble. In the famous 3 years same interviews she did with Vanity Fair, Billie said that she was very grateful for everything that has happened to her and is tired of complaining. She believed that she has complained way too much. There are so many people who love to wallow in their misery. This girl is for sure way more mature for her age. Billie confessed that she's learned a lot and not to take anything for granted. She knows that she is successful, but for her, the most important thing is to maintain her happiness. And in the same interview, she mentioned that after so many years, she finally has started feeling happy and she's trying to figure out how to get used to receiving so much attention, as she's only going to be more famous than what she already is. Throughout all of Billie's ups and downs, one person has stuck around, and that is her brother. The friendship these two have with one another is priceless. Pretty much in every interview, she mentions that Phineas is her best friend, who happens to be her brother too. Oh, and they create music together as well. A magical duo. Some fans even say that Phoenix's girlfriend, Claudia Solowski, looks exactly like Billy, but I won't go that far. What do you guys think? Do you believe Billy and Claudia look alike? To give you an idea of how much these two support each other, I'm gonna tell you about one of the recent songs they created together called Everything I Wanted. In the song, Billy talks about a nightmare she has had where she committed suicide and saw that no one, fans or friends, cared about her passing. Billy's nightmare ends when she wakes up and sees that Phoenix is by her side, and he says, "As long as I'm here, no one can hurt you." I don't know about you guys, but every time my girl listens to this song, I see her tears running down. Since Billy has become famous, she's talked about how fame has not been treating her well multiple times. She kept on having dark thoughts and sleep paralysis. Since childhood, Billy has been suffering from body dysmorphic disorder, and she's been dealing with depression as well. Her struggles with her body image are the reason why she is wearing baggy clothes all the time to cover it up. At the age of 12, she joined a competitive dance company, and that was when she was most insecure. That time was peak of her body dysmorphia. She couldn't even look at herself in the mirror, but she did love dancing, so that was what kept her going. After rupturing the growth plate in her hip, she had to quit dancing, and that was when the depression hit her hard. It sent her down a hole. She went through a whole self-harming phase, but the gist of it was that she felt like she deserved to be in pain. Poor Billy. I can't imagine what she was going through, not being able to do what she loves the most. But one good thing is that her brother and her family were always there for her. Fortunately, as I said before, it seems like the singer is overcoming many of the difficulties that fame brought her. And 2019 looked like Billy's year if you ask anyone. Billy is overcoming all the darkness and demons, and the fans are very happy to see her this happy. I hope she keeps on having that beautiful smile on her face because we, fans, want to see her the happiest. Okay, my time is up here. What do you guys think about Billie Eilish's career? Do you think she deserves all the success she has achieved? Do you think she will become way more famous than what she already is now? Let's talk about all of that in the comments, and remember to like and share and become part of our Curious Subs family by subscribing to our channel. Until next time!